With the election quickly approaching, all of the propositions on the ballot can get confusing. Today, we'll be talking to people who are directly affected by them, or those who know someone who will be affected. Prop 17 looks to restore the right to vote to state parolees, or to people directly after they've been released from prison.
I strongly believe that no one should have their right to vote taken away, that their perspective is very important, that it be included within the perspectives of all the rest of us, the perspective that is carried right by our vote. I also think that that for their own rehabilitation, make them think that they've been exiled from society, I think that hurts their chances for effective rehabilitation. If we keep them close, right, keep them involved in the life of the Republic, I think it's very helpful for them and thereby helpful for all of us.
Some SDSU alum believe that restoring parolees' right to vote will make them feel more socially accepted and engaged in their community again.
But it does have some type of social impact where you feel more acceptable to society. So it is going to have somewhat of an impact. I mean, once I got off paperwork and, you know, from my example, I got off paperwork and I know I can vote now. And even the DMV sent me the paperwork like, hey, you want to vote? I felt more acceptable, like, to the system or to the government, to the state. I felt like a little bit more of a part of the country.
The state Senate and Assembly are both in favor of passing this proposition. If passed, about 50,000 new voters would be registered, and the total cost of it would be less than 1% of the state's current general fund budget.
Or, like, the system is, like, designed in a way, like, almost to, like, disenfranchise minorities, and not allowing people to vote on parole, to me, is, like the new Jim Crow. If you look at statistically who's being incarcerated, who's on parole, it's so heavily male. I think it's black males are the highest. 1 in 3 black men have a record by the time they're 30. And because it's like a reoccurring door, basically these people are never getting off of parole to be able to vote. So it's like their voice never matters.
What way will you be voting for Prop 17 and the rest of the propositions? We'll keep you updated on their outcomes and more election-related issues. And for the Daily Aztec, I'm Caitlin Nguyen.